We are presenting product promotion, so we'll move ahead and I'll ask my teammate to
So basically, we'll be starting from the definition. We'll be starting from the definition of product promotion. So as you all know that promotion is the fourth element of marketing mix, that is of four P's: product, price, place, and promotion. The promotion means giving the information about the product or product line or brand to the potential customers with an intent to generate sales and develop brand loyalty. However, the objectives of promotions are such as providing the information about available features and uses of the product that is being promoted, and also to stimulate the demand by creating awareness and interest among the audience or the potential customers by differentiating the product from other competitor products. Like in the market, if there are already the products present from the competitors, by promotions we will be differentiating the product of a certain company, why it is best suitable for the consumers, and also to stabilize the sales by highlighting the importance and its features, like by highlighting the features that a certain product of our company is having, which gives the edge over other competitor products are being listed, and by giving this interest is generated in the potential customers. Next slide, please. So there are four different kinds of promotions, and they are informative promotion, persuasive promotion, reminder promotion, buyer behavior modifications. Coming to informative promotion, it can be taken place during every stage of the product life cycle. Right from introduction to that of the maturity phase, every phase includes this informative kind of promotion. Customer generally buys a product only if he has all the relevant information being told about the product. And the informative promotion creates primary demand in the consumers. Persuasive promotion. It is followed during the growth stage of product. It generally means to persuade the people to buy by stimulating purchase and create a positive image of the product in the consumers. It also influences the long-term behavior of customers. It involves high-pressure selling, so only few of the companies takes that because it cannot be done by every other company. Generally, the startups which are trying to just now trying to penetrate into the market will not be taking up the persuasive promotion, whereas they will be going towards the more kind of informative promotions. And then comes reminder promotion. This will be taken up during the maturity stage of the product. This is done to keep the product alive in the minds of the customers. Like, more emphasis is made upon the brand name so as to make the brand loyal consumers and customers aware that the product is still in the market. And the final kind of promotion is buyer behavior modification. In this, there is the access promotion basing upon the modifications of the consumer behavior. Constant personal selling and repeated advertisements are the schemes that are adopted in wake of the behavioral modifications that can be seen in the potential customers. And next slide. This will be continued by my friends.
Yes, I'll continue this, and this is the promotion strategies that usually companies apply. So the first one is social media promotion, where the promotion is done on the social media like Facebook and Instagram. The environment there is relaxed, and the targeting can be done very easily over social media. Second is mail ordering mail order marketing, where we receive mails and different kind of from companies. Wherever we have registered, they will start mailing us. So that is second promotion strategy. Then the third comes giveaways and samples. Some ways we will see that companies have taken up a stall, a small stall in malls, and they are just giving you the samples to just taste, give it a taste or something. Then there is point of sale promotion and end cap marketing, which involves direct store marketing. Means outside the store, you can see the clothes are hanging, there is showing that sales at 50% discount and everything. So that is the promotional strategy, which is called point sale promotion. And the next one is customer referral incentive program, where we must have seen, like the company Amway, they use a promotion of their customers. Means they go by a pyramid strategy, yeah, where they'll ask your customer to make two other customers. So that is the customer referral incentive program. Then causes and charity, where a company acknowledges itself or portrays itself as a company which is doing something for the society, or their product is doing something for the society. So, and then moving on, branded promotional gifts, and means branded promotional gifts, gifts where
like your gift, t-shirts, your mugs, your cups.
Yes, yes, sir. Cups and just like sir said, it is there. And then there comes customer appreciation events, where small events are conducted by companies and customers are invited. Free refreshments are given, and their customers are not bound to buy anything, but they just come there to look at the product, and promotion is done through that.
Yeah.
Then there's after sale customer surveys, where like the mail thing, they will mail you to ask your opinion and everything, and this gives them a scope to even promote their next product.
Yes,
I'll take these slides. So this is about the product promotion models. So basically, the product promotion blends, we have two kind of blends out there. The first one is actually the push blend, and another one is the pull blend. Now let me talk about the push blend. You know what is push blend is actually, it is a sales basically. The sale, that is the pushing into, the product is pushing into the wholesalers, and the wholesaler is actually pushing the product into the retailers, and retailers basically pushing the models into the consumers. Now it comes to the pull blend model. The pull blend model is actually, you know, the directly the producers, they are going for, you know, spending a lot of monies to get an advertisement, and directly that creates a demand in the consumers. Yeah. Let's see the next slide actually. I will explain it clearly in the next slide. Yeah, this is a strategy. See here. Wow. Now the producer promote aggressively the product into the wholesalers. You can see the arrows, you know, in the left side, what is push model is representing there. So, you know, producers promote aggressively the product into the wholesalers. From wholesalers, you know, again, it aggressively promotes into the retailers. And from retailers, again, into the consumers. So finally, the consumer, like, they got the product. You know, like, now the pull model, how it works. The producers directly promoting the product into the consumers. It's a direct awareness is happening in this particular way. So I think, I hope you have understand about the two kind of models. Okay, continue.
Persuasive promotional activities. These are relevant at the growth stage of the product. Primary objective of the management is to persuade people to buy the product. Persuasive promotional activities are used to change a buyer's attitude or convince them to buy your product or service. And we also need to use persuasive promotion strategies to explain how your product is better or different than your competition offerings, and why the prospective buyer should go with your company. And encouraging buyers to make a purchase immediately, to buy more than they would normally buy at regular price, or to increase their use of your product or service is another use of persuasive tactics. The basic purpose of this promotion strategy is to stimulate purchase, create a positive image of the project in the mind of customers, so that influencing the long-term behaviors.
Sure.
Now moving on to some practical applicability that we have seen around the world. So first of all, I'd like to put forth the case of Samsung, where Samsung, how it did the strategy, how it segmented, and then how it positioned its marketing strategy on the field. So in start, everybody knows that Samsung was not that much of bigger brand. So what Mr. Yoon did, the CEO, the MD of that company, what he did, he targeted the younger generation, as because it was completely technologically driven brand. So he started targeting the younger generation, as because from younger generation, the both, because younger generation are the guiding thread of both the generation, the older one also or the newer one also. So he targeted the younger one. Apart from that, he also invested heavily in research and development. I'd like to draw the attention towards the 2008 and 2009 recession, where many companies were not able to stand its foot on the ground. But what Samsung did, it invested more than 25% of its investment in R&D, and that somewhere paved their path. And apart from that, they were on their path to excel the motives by targeting the younger generation. That was the main motive. The next slide. Now the Cadbury. I have purposely put the case study of Cadbury as because their marketing lines, their advertisements, kuch meetha ho jaye type, and then khane walon ko khane ka. So this was what Cadbury did. It tapped the advertisement potential of themselves. So I won't go further as because of time constraint. So thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Phenomenal.
Sir, I'll quote it now.
Great job. Yeah, fantastic. You covered it so well. Yes, promotion, product promotion. I think, you know.
Thank you, sir.
Good job. Congratulations. I'm so happy. You people must be reading those chat messages. You know, I really love those appreciative messages. More than the people who are getting appreciated, I love those people who are appreciating, you know.